Who is Jesus? Some names he's been called are Rabbi, the Messiah, Savior, the Great I Am, the Son of Man, the list goes on. He came to earth as a human, just like you and me. During his time on earth, he performed numerous miracles such as raising people from the dead and healing the sick. He had a close group of 12 disciples, or people who followed him. He was proclaimed to be the Savior of the world, a fulfillment of the prophecies in the Old Testament.
On the evening of the Passover supper, Jesus arrived with the 12 disciples. As they were sitting around the table, Jesus said, "One of you eating with me will betray me." The disciples were all distressed and asked him if it was them. Jesus replied that the Son of Man will go just as it is written about him. In Matthew 26:26-28, it states that as they were eating, Jesus took bread and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for the forgiveness of sins."
Judas, one of Jesus' 12 apostles, went to the chief priests to discuss how he could betray Jesus in exchange for money. As Jesus was still praying on the Mount of Olives, Judas appeared with a crowd armed with swords and clubs. Mark 14:44 says, "Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. 'The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard.' Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, 'Rabbi,' and kissed him. The men seized Jesus and arrested him."
Jesus was presented before the governor, who questioned him in front of the people. The crowd shouted to crucify Jesus, though he had not been found guilty of any crime. The soldiers took him, stripped him, and put a crown of thorns on his head. They beat him, spit on him, and finally crucified him on a cross. The next day at 3 p.m, Jesus, nearly dead, cried out loud, "My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" With this, he took his last breath and died. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. God paid that debt by giving us his Son to carry the weight of the world. Soon after his death, Jesus' body was buried in a tomb with a large stone covering the entrance.
3 days later, the woman who had come to Jesus from Galilee were startled to find that the stone was rolled away and his body was not there. As they were wondering about this, two angels appeared to them. In Luke chapter 24, verse 6, the angels say, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, he has risen." The woman remembered these words and told them to the apostles. At first, they didn't believe it, but Peter went to the tomb and was shocked.
After rising from the dead, Jesus went out and appeared to many people in order to show that he had fulfilled his initial prophecy and dispel any doubts of his resurrection. As he went, Jesus instructed those he saw to share the good news with everyone about how he had conquered death. After 40 days on earth, Jesus gathered his disciples and spoke to them what is now known as the Great Commission, which essentially acts as Jesus' last instructions to his disciples, but ultimately to all Christians past, present, and future. The Great Commission is what drives the church forward to share the gospel, and is also when Jesus leaves the Holy Spirit with all believers. After sharing the Great Commission, Jesus ascends back into heaven, leaving the earth until he one day returns again.
"All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of age." Now I have